Dear guests, we request you to kindly stand to honor the class of 2017 entering with the procession. May we request the entire graduating class and all guests to kindly take their seat. May we now request our faculty to kindly move to their respective chairs. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. May we request you to kindly put your cell phones on a silent mode. Thank you. I, Preeti Miranda, Registrar Academic Administration at SPJIMR, take this honor to welcome you all to the SPJIMR Graduation Ceremony 2017. Inaugurated in 1981 by the late British Prime Minister, Honorable Miss Margaret Thatcher, and nurtured by our former Honorable Dean, late Dr. Manesh L. Srikant, SPJIMR has moved from strength to strength for close to four decades now. Standing at the cusp of two contrasting societies, one that has and the other that only hopes to have, we at SPJIMR realized that we have the heart to address either society and the courage to stand by them all the time. This makes us a globally recognized, unique, beyond MBA institution. Brought up under such a mandate, year after year, our graduating batches have established SPJIMR's unflinching commitment towards both the industry and the underserved sections of the society. I would now request our chairman, SPJIMR Board of Governors, Shri Deepak Parekh, to commence proceedings of the evening.
I declare the graduation ceremony of 2017 open.
Thank you, sir. I now request the following dignitaries to please come forward and light the auspicious lamp. Our chief guest, Dr. R. A. Mashelkar, Shri Deepak Parekh, our Dean, Dr. Ranjan Baranji, SPJIMR Governing Council members, Dr. Seshayar and Dr. Renuka Kamath, kindly come forward, please. Thank you all. I request Ms. Vasanti Jayaraman to recite the prayer, please.
Kuntintu Tushar Harada या शुभ्रवस्त्रावृता यागीनां वरदण्डमण्डितकरा या श्वेतपद्मासना या ब्रह्माच्युत शङ्कर प्रभृति सरस्वती भगवती निःशेष जाड्या
Thank you, Asanti ma'am, for the lovely rendition. I now request our Dean, Dr. Ranjan Banerjee, to give the welcome address.
Respected Chief Guest, Dr. Raghunath Mashelkar, a Padma Vibhushan and a globally known thought leader in the area of innovation, Chairman of our Governing Council, Ms. Deepak Parikh, also the Chairman of HDFC, nationally known business leader, heads of our sister institutions, representatives from partner companies and guests, chairpersons of our programs, faculty colleagues, staff members, family members and friends of our graduating students, and last but definitely not the least, students from the graduating class of 2017. I extend a hearty welcome to each and every one of you to this graduation ceremony. The mission of the Institute is to influence practice and provide value-based growth. We also see ourselves as a school of management, and one implication of this is that we impact society through programs and initiatives that aim to take management education to segments currently underserved by the business school community. We take pride in being first to market with relevant programs to address social needs. Based on faculty feedback in 2015 and internal ideation, earlier this year we launched the Management Program for Women, India's first ever program to bring talented women leaders back to the workplace. It is a unique program in that a mandatory condition for entry is presence of a career break. Corporate interest has been high, with many reputed companies like Mahindra, Larsen & Toubro, Axis Bank, Cummins and others signing up as partners. There are many unique dimensions to this program, including the assignment of a certified coach to each participant, a focus on career and identity, in addition to conventional management inputs. Early feedback suggests that the students of this program are among the most committed and enthusiastic students in the Institute. Faculty report that every student reads the case study fully and comes well prepared to the class. We believe that this program will grow, and many supplementary partnerships in the areas of preparing high potential women leaders within organizations have emerged as a consequence. Your institute has always prided itself on teaching excellence. Our excellence in pedagogy has received external recognition. Harvard Business Publishing has selected SPJIMR as the national partner for running a set of teaching with simulations workshops for faculty at leading business schools. Over 60 faculty from across the country and faculty from institutions like IIM Ahmedabad, the Indian School of Business, IIM Lucknow, IIM Indore, XLRI, NMIMS, NITI, among others, have benefited from these workshops. We have also taken tangible steps to strengthen the R in SPJMR, that is research. In the current year, we launched a fellow program in management. All our students of the first batch are management graduates from reputed institutes, as the enthusiasm and commitment of our first batch of researchers in the making has impressed many. We have modeled our PhD curriculum on the research traditions at the top research universities in the US and UK. And in the next few months, faculty from institutes like Cornell, Carnegie Mellon, Carlson, Minnesota, London School of Economics, and London Business School will join our faculty to deliver research seminars for our FPM cohort. We believe this has the potential to be one of the country's best doctoral programs, and that will be our endeavor in years to come. A behavioral lab and a poverty action lab are also in the wings, and a much stronger position in research and thought leadership will move us further towards influencing practice. One of the areas where we always felt we needed to improve is in the area of living experience and infrastructure, and we have made significant progress on this front. Now, if you chance to enter the institute from the main entrance, there is a different and transformed facade to the campus, which is beginning to be visible. A second phase of campus upgradation is underway, and we will soon have a lake which looks and feels more like a lake. A new hostel block is under construction, and the imminent opening of an office annex will mean that the day is not far away when places for the SPJMR community to hang out together will no longer be in short supply. As an institute, we take great pride in the faculty-student relationship within our institute. It is one of our greatest strengths, and I draw on both this strength and our deep attachment to every outgoing student to frame my final message to the outgoing batch. In our institute, we talk about influence without power. It is a simple idea, yet a powerful one. It suggests that irrespective of your position, if you understand people, if you empathize, if you listen and understand the environment, through small actions, you can shape that environment in your own way. In the words of Steve Jobs, the minute that you understand that you can poke life and something will pop out the other side, that you can change it, that you can mold it, that's maybe the most important thing. Once you learn that, you'll never be the same again. Too often, we see success as a matter of doing what the environment expects of us. Leaders do not just adapt to the world, they shape it in positive ways. When this is done with humility and the willingness to learn, it gives you soft power, the sort of power that can truly influence practice. This is my final message to you, our students. You are SPJIMR. You were cut and bred from a different cloth. You can, will, and must make a difference. As you do so, remember that there are people at your institute watching you, cheering for you, ready to hold you when you fall, and taking pride in the difference that you make. I wish you fulfillment, happiness, and the courage to be the best that you can be on a day-to-day basis. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I now request our chairman, Sri Deepak Parekh, to introduce our honorable chief guest for this evening.
Chief guest Dr. Mashelkar, our Dean Ranjan Banerjee, members of the faculty, parents, dear students, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great pleasure to have the honor of introducing our chief guest, Dr. Mashelkar. How do I introduce a person, such a prolific and multifaceted individual like Dr. Mashelkar? He's a path-breaking scientist, deeply connected with India's innovation movement. I would have been happy to read out Dr. Mashelkar's CV, but his achievements are so many that I don't want to take time. We'd rather hear him than list his achievements. You should get the picture when I say that so far he has been awarded 37 honorary doctorate from around the world, from Australia to America, and 50 awards. He's the only person I know who has been awarded by the Government of India a Padma Shri, a Padma Bhushan and a Padma Vibhushan in 2014. But let me try of introducing Dr. Mashelkar in another manner. First, he's my friend. The reason why he is here today is because we struck a barter deal. A few months ago, Dr. Mashelkar asked me to be the chief guest at a memorial function in Pune. I readily agreed, knowing that I could get a favor back from him. So when the Dean, Dr. Ranjan Banerjee, asked me to think about a chief guest, it took me no time. And Dr. Mashelkar was so accommodating. He normally spends the month of April in Australia at a Melbourne University. But he's postponed that by 2 weeks and he's here today. As you heard, Dr. Mashelkar calls himself as a dangerous optimist. But only real visionaries dare to dream big. He says, don't leapfrog, pole vault instead. Leapfrogging is restrictive. But in pole vaulting, the size of your pole will determine how far you will go. My favorite quote of his is on frugal engineering. It is so true when he says, innovation in India should follow the mantra, more from less for more. This means producing more with fewer ingredients, but enjoyed by far many more people. Lastly, I'm told that Dr. Mashelkar has come up with a new formula to energize India. So clearly it is time that we debunk Einstein E equals to MC square and adopt Mashelkar's formula, which is E is equal to F. E is education, F is future. It's a simple formula with a lot of clarity. Education is equal to the future. Like Dr. Mashelkar, I too wish I was decades younger, simply because India's best days are yet to come. I wish I was sitting there and getting a degree today. Students, the future is yours to make. The best opportunities are going to unfold and are unfolding. I can see it. It's going to be very exciting in India in the next decades. And always let your moral compass face true north. India needs many more Mashelkars. India needs many more optimists, dangerous optimists, pole vaulters, and mindsets, innovators. And we hope many of you will achieve that. With these words, let me once again thank Dr. Mashelkar to accepting our invitation and being here with us as our chief guest. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Today is a very special day for us. We are proud to have graduating batches from three different programs presenting three different profiles of participants, each with a portfolio of distinguished achievements. I will now request the program chairs to present their batch reports. We will start with the oldest program at SPJMR and move to the newer ones, beginning with the two-year PGDM program. I request Dr. Vasan Shivaraman, Program Chair and Senior Faculty in Strategy and Finance, to present the PGDM batch report.
Distinguished Chief Guest, Dr. Raghunath Mashelkar, Chairman Board of Governors, Mr. Deepak Parekh, Dean Dr. Ranjan Banerjee, my colleagues, guests, and the proud graduating class of 2017. A graduation ceremony is always a special occasion. Pride and joy mark this day for the participants, their friends, and families. As the graduates start a new beginning and join the alumni body of SPJMR, I'd like to present a report of the PGDM class of 2017. Being accepted in the program in itself is a mountain to climb, and that was the first peak. The 2 years on campus have been demanding in what is a distinct program, but you have grown and transformed as individuals. SPJMR is recognized for pedagogic innovations which have helped the institute stand out in the field of management education. There were a few firsts for the batch of 2015-17. Among them was the introduction of a minor area of concentration. This initiative allowed a choice of minor beyond the area of major specialization. The options for a minor included analytics, consulting, finance, information management, marketing, and operations and supply chain. The batch had the opportunity to choose a minor area in addition to greater flexibility relative to the past to choose and change their main or major specialization in the second year. This provided more leeway in the specialization base as also in a career track. By way of some light stats, the class of 2017 was offered about 140 courses in order to earn 60 credits required to complete the program. That's a range of choice that might make one sit up. The entire batch completed specialized courses at world-class partner schools. In this immersion, our participants undertook coursework, field visits, and projects at Cornell University, Carnegie Mellon University, University of Virginia, and Michigan State University. In addition to this, 32 participants signed up for international exchange programs in diverse schools such as ISEC in France, Dauphine in France, KEDGE in France, ESB in Germany, and Nagoya in Japan. It's not all work and no play. The cultural festival run by the batch, OGES 9, had a theme of around the world and continued to build on its standing among management schools. Sprint, the annual sports festival at SPJMR run by the batch, had 12 institutes from across the country participating. On completing a decade, Sprint has now risen to be the second largest business school sports festival in India. This year, the overall trophy was again won by SPJMR. Since 2003, each batch hosts a play. As with every year, the production by GASP of the class of 2017 was clearly a standout event in terms of popular vote. Moving on to social projects, the class of 2017 undertook internships with 66 NGOs in 24 states in rural areas across India, Nepal, and Bangladesh. These projects were in the areas of health, education, infrastructure, women empowerment, social entrepreneurship, and income generation, to name a few. Design thinking was integrated with the social projects, which we now see as enhancing the outcomes for the NGOs. On the front of co-curricular activities, the participants of the PGDM class of 2017 won a number of accolades in various competitions, including those hosted by premier business schools and corporates like Nestle, Johnson & Johnson, and L&T. As in the past, a winning entry from the batch was invited to participate in the St. Gallen Symposium at Switzerland. On placements, The batch has continued with the winning track record that we are known for. Recruiters included Accenture, TAS, Deloitte, Mahindra, P&G, HUL, Paytm, L'Oreal, and LinkedIn, to name a few. Companies visiting campus included 51 first-time recruiters this year. On a personal note, this was my first batch as chair, from your orientation day through to your graduation day. That makes yours a special batch for me and for the program team. I'd like to acknowledge the staff, my faculty colleagues, for making the program what it is. We wish you everything that you so richly deserve in the years ahead. It's been an honor and privilege for all of us to watch your progress and success. Heartfelt congratulations to each one of you, and we all wish you the very best in your next phase of life. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We now have batch report of the 21-month PGEMP for working executives to be presented by Program Chair Dr. Renuka Kamath, who is also a Governing Council member and senior faculty in marketing. Ma'am.
Distinguished Chief Guest, Dr. Raghunath Mashelkar, Chairman Board of Governors, Mr. Deepak Parekh, Dean Dr. Banerjee, my colleagues, our guests, and my dear students. The Postgraduate Executive Management Program, PGEMP, a program for working executives, was started 15 years back, conceived with the unique model of partnership with industry's leading corporates. It has been a journey that has seen 61 batches joining SPJMR. We are ready to start our 62nd batch next month. Today, our partner companies who are represented in the graduating batches are L&T, BPCL, Shapoorji Pallonji Group, Tata Capital, Mahindra, Ambuja Cement, India Medtronic, eClux, Emerson, PPG Asian Paints, VA Tech, Webag, and Bristlecone. The PGEMP program is a 21-month long journey that working executives undertake while continuing their job. The academic schedule is extremely demanding and the rigor almost punishing, both when they are on campus and also off campus in between the contacts. Some of us can only imagine how challenging it may be for anyone to study and continue working full time. And that is not all. You have to also take care of the most important part of your lives, your families, your partners, children, and parents. I'm quite sure it has been a draining journey for you. Your families, who have also sacrificed so much, would be extremely happy for you, as they would be to have their weekends back with you. Some highlights of the graduating batches of EMP. The inauguration of our Golden Jubilee Batch 50 was a momentous occasion for us. It was a landmark of sorts, as some of our pioneering corporate partners saw us achieve this. Today, to see the Golden Jubilee Batch graduating gives us so much pride. We began the Design Thinking course last year, a course that has been highly appreciated, as well as added value to those who went ahead with implementation in their organization. PGEMP batches live by SPJMR stories of courage and heart. While they study, there are no boundaries for the kind gestures we have seen from them. One such instance is when students of batch 51, 46 of them, got together and made personal voluntary donation amounting to more than a lakh of rupees to Abhyudaya. SPJMR's Abhyudaya is a program under the aegis of which our PGDM students mentor bright, underprivileged students from neighboring schools. We are perhaps the only business school in India to do so. This gesture will go a long way in supporting it. And we know we are certainly doing well when we have applicants from outside India applying for PGEMP. Students who used to come from Middle East and South Africa are graduating today. Imagine now, you sit in a class and in walks a clown or a cartoonist or a chocolatier, a stand-up comedian, or even a detective. It surely is PGEMP's A class thodi hatke. We believe in value-driven education that is not restricted merely to texts, assignments, and exams. The greatest education comes from life itself and from lives of people around us who have taken different professional paths. Introduction of A class thodi hatke has ensured learning through fun, chat sessions, and many workshops. Well, PGEMP has some unique stories. In the past, we had a father from PGEMP and his son from PGDM graduating on the same day on the same stage. Today, we have a participant graduating whose husband graduated last year on the same stage exactly a year back and is now an alumnus of PGEMP. Well, that's something. Fireworks for that. Yeah. So last year she was cheering for her husband, and today he is in the audience cheering for her. We have Rahul Tandon there, who's given Mugdha a surprise. One day, one thing I can confidently say for the PGEMP batch is that you will be nostalgic when you hear words like contact schedule, Moodle, eKosh, group works, off-campus assignment, provisional guest sheets, roundups with me, mentors' quarterly reports, Vrindavan ka khana with the green and red gravy, sleepy yoga sessions at 6:30 a.m. Dear participants, you're going to be SPJMR alumni. We know we can count on you to keep our flag flying high. We hold exclusive PGEMP alumni meets, which are hugely attended. We look forward to seeing you there and at other institute events. I thank all the guests from our partner companies and the mentors of participants who have taken time out to join us today. A special thanks to my strong team of batch coordinators, research associates, and administrative colleagues who have been relentless in their commitment. On a final note, I consider myself fortunate to have taught students from all three programs graduating today. My heartiest congratulations to all the graduating participants who have made it to this day. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. We will now have the 15-month PGPM batch report to be presented by Dr. Suresh Lalwani, Program Chair and Senior Faculty in Finance. Sir.
Thank you. Distinguished Chief Guest Dr. Raghunath Mashelkar, Chairman Board of Governors Sri Deepak Parekh, Dean Dr. Ranjan Banerjee, my faculty colleagues and admin colleagues, guests and graduating participants, I congratulate the PGPM class of 2016 as also the PGDM and the PGEMP batches for their successful graduation today. PGPM is a high-rigor program that imparts career acceleration to mid-management professionals. It strengthens functional capabilities and develops cross-functional business acumen and managerial skills. Hence, our participants can assume larger responsibilities since recruiting companies see them as drivers of business growth. This outcome is challenging, and to achieve it, PGPM participants must display exemplary professional commitment and courage. They bear the highest opportunity cost incurred by any MBA aspirant. The cost involved in leaving behind good jobs and, in many cases, the high non-financial costs of staying away from spouses and children. Not to forget the willpower needed to return to the rigors of full-time campus life after about 7 years at work. The genesis of the PGPM program lies in the institute's conviction that industry needs committed and competent talent at lateral levels. talent that will drive business growth and differentiation. Hence, relevance to business is a top priority, and the program design and flow is constantly fine-tuned with inputs from industry, our acclaimed faculty, global best practices, and student feedback. I'm happy to present the batch report for the PGPM class of 2016. The graduating batch has contributed significantly to the PGPM growth story. The class is full of multifarious and live-wire talent. Great learners and contributors, high on curiosity, focused and ambitious. They enhance the growth legacy of the program across dimensions like largest batch size, rich experience, skills and competencies, high functional and domain diversity, and a robust placement record, high on qualitative and quantitative aspects. They started their on-campus journey in January 2016 with 150 participants, 18 female and 132 male, with average age 29 years, average experience 7 years. They came from 70 different companies across a multitude of sectors and geographies, national and global. The multifaceted caliber of the class was a display throughout the year by wholehearted participation and regular winning outcomes in competitions relating to business, case studies, quizzes, paper presentations, sports, and music. Between hosting seasoned business leaders in conclaves, panel discussions, COPAL or Coffee with PGPM alumni sessions, to regular publishing of papers and articles under the guidance of our faculty, the class of 2016 has done a lot. With the largest ever batch size, the class offered a diverse pool of top-notch experienced talent to recruiters. The year witnessed a surge in new recruiters due to the attractive talent pool. To name a few, Fidelity Investments, Shell, SAP, Salesforce, Sapient, Freshdesk, Cipla, Capillary Technologies, etc. Despite macro environment challenges, virtually all recruiters from past placement cycles participated this year. A total of 60 organizations consisting of 105 SBUs made 129 mid-management offers in varied functions and domains. To name a few, Amazon, Microsoft, SAP, Fidelity, J&J, Salesforce, Syntel, Emphasis, and many others were passionately sought and converted by our talented bunch of participants. The class of 2016 raised the bar on placement growth metrics in a challenging year. A glimpse of key metrics over the last 2 years will give a sense. In the CTC 18 to 30 lakhs category, the number of job offers increased from 9 to 19 to 38, an increase from 8 to 14 to 30% of the batch size this year. The batch-wise increase over incoming CTC rose from 35 to 71 to 77% this year. This is evidence, and we also have feedback, that recruiters see tremendous potential in PGPM participants. In tangible term, this relates to their in-depth knowledge and enthusiasm, problem-solving skills, analytical and articulation skills, laced, of course, with their experience. Not to forget the inputs and support they receive at the institute. On a personal note, this was the first batch I had the privilege of serving end-to-end as the chair. In that sense, too, they are special. In conclusion, the PGPM class of 2016 has indeed made its mark. I am sure they have enjoyed themselves in doing so, as have my team and me in being there for them. I must thank my wonderful team at PGPM and all faculty and staff at the institute who have contributed to the program and brought it to its current high standards. Once again, heartiest congratulations and the best of wishes to all graduates for a wonderful future, a happy life, and a satisfying career. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We now move to the presentation of scholastic awards known as Dean's Top Honours. May I request our Honourable Chief Guest, Dr. R. A. Mashelkar, to kindly felicitate the awardees, and Sri Deepak Parekh to kindly hand over the certificates. The awardees will be invited program-wise and names will be called out in alphabetical order. After receiving your certificate, please stand along with our chief guest and chairman for your photograph. Please pause for 2 seconds and look at the camera. This is your moment and you deserve the best shot. I request all the PGDM DTT awardees to please come towards the stage. Request Program Chair Dr. Vasant Shivraman to present them one by one.
The PGDM Scholastic Awardees Dean's Top 20. Alumna Ankit Kite. Antariksh Banerjee, Anubhav Agarwal, IV Abhishek, Ipshita Priyadarshini Sai, Ishan Anaukar, Jyotirmoy Mazumdar, Nitin Davesar, Payal Niharika, Prakar Gupta, Sahil Bhayana, Samir Mange, Satish S. Shoaib Ahmed, Silky Sandhu, Smita Gupta, Saurav Sen, Sushant Jaggi, Tushar Salonkhe, Vismay Harani,
thank you, Vasant sir. So we'll request you to wait, please. I request all the PGEMP DTT awardees to please come towards the stage. Request Program Chair Dr. Renuka Kamat to present them one by one, beginning with Batch 47.
Amit Sharma, Sanjeev Sood, Sanjeev Sood, Batch 48, A. Kamal Raj, Gayatri Galvankar, Shriram Iyer, Batch 49, Amar Vagani, Gaurav Jain, Saurabh Doshi, Batch 50, Gopalakrishnan M, Pinku Mahanta, Sunil Pandare, Batch 51, Rupesh M, Sushmita Mitra, Tyagarajan S, oops, Batch 52, Hussein Virani, Muthu Kumar T, Rahul Adhikari,
thank you, Renuka ma'am. I request all the PGPM DTT awardees to please come towards the stage. Request Program Chair Dr. Suresh Lalwani to present them one by one.
The PGPM Scholastic Awardees, Dean's Top 10, Ashish Parakh, Hardik Mirani, Harsha Atluri, Manish Sharma, Rajat Gupta, Rishabh Bajaj, Sneha Nagarajan, the following participants are on the Dean's top 10 list but could not attend: Sanju Nair, Swati Krishna and Yashwin Chandiramani.
Thank you, sir, and thank you very much, Dr. Mashilkar and Sri Deepak Parekh, for the felicitations. I now have the pleasure of inviting our honorable chief guest for the evening, Dr. Raghunath Anant Mashilkar, to kindly address the graduating class of 2017.
Most respected Deepak Bhai Parekh, our chairman of Board of Governors, Dr. Ranjan Banerjee, distinguished personalities on the dais, distinguished faculty, proud graduates of the day, their equally proud parents, my friends. I consider it a singular honor and a special privilege to deliver the convocation address of this great institution. I watched with admiration the great march forward of the institution with a truly global outlook, extraordinary global reach, and a powerful global imprint. I want to begin by congratulating the graduates of the day, their teachers, and their parents. Education is the best gift you all parents would have given to your children. My dear graduates, you will be stepping out of the portal of this institute today in a world that is full of opportunities and also full of challenges. India today is not just being looked at as a third world country, it is being looked at as potentially the third most powerful country in the world. My young friends, it is going to be your responsibility to build this great future of our great nation. I must make a little deviation from my written speech because Deepak Bhai, while introducing me, talked about something that I need to explain to you. He talked about what I consider as the most powerful equation, E equal to F, education is equal to future. The challenge with scientists is that any equation that is proposed, they have to give the proof. And the day will not be complete if I don't give the proof of that. So let me give that proof by taking a little deviation from my speech. I was born in a very, very poor family. My father died when I was 6. My mother was illiterate. She brought me to Mumbai. She did some menial jobs, brought me up, two meals a day was a challenge. And I remember, although I had stood 11th among 135,000 students in the Maharashtra State SSC board, I was going to leave studies because my mother could not afford my education. And then came Sir Dorabji Tata Trust, and they gave me 60 rupees per month for 6 years. That is how I could study. That is how I am here. And the proof of the equation E equal to F comes this very afternoon. The same Bombay house from where I used to collect those 60 rupees every month, I was there in that Bombay house as a chairman of their affirmative action committee, which across the Tata group actually select those companies who have done the best work in terms of inclusion, looking at the poor and doing something for them. Can you just imagine the same boy who walked barefoot until he was 12 and survived on the basis of 60 rupees per month, today become the chairman of Tata Trust?